What's up, guys? I'm Malcolm back to Software and Audio Solutions, and today we're talking about Call of Duty Warzone Season 3 Reloaded. Now, ladies and gentlemen, they've released a reloaded version for Call of Duty right now. Now, there is a ranked play, which is in beta version, which I'm kind of hating on the developers for it. The main reason why I'm hating on the developers for that, the ranked version of the fucking game, is that it's beta. Call of Duty doesn't know what to do with themselves anymore. The developers don't know what to do with themselves anymore, and I think they're just shitting out stuff now. They released the beta version. It's quite broken, and I think Call of Duty should have just fucking waited until they released the ranked game. They should have released the game as ranked, not beta, not a beta version of the fucking ranked version. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, this is the website for everything you need to know about the new update, and I had to go through all of this bullshit for you guys to be able to find out what is the best settings to be able to play ranked mode and stuff like that, because a lot of people are getting FPS loss, just bullshit in general, the game not running correctly, the game crashing, the game not like just loading into the game, the servers has crashed, or it's telling you your achievements are still loading. Like, what the actual fuck, COD? Like, what are you guys doing? Can you just release something that fucking works for a change? Why? Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, this is the webpage. I'll leave a link in the description down below if you want to go in detail with reading all this bullshit. I had to go ahead and do that, so yeah. This is pretty much the reloaded version. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's jump over the settings for you guys for the best settings you can use right now for the ranked beta version. Yeah, beta. Let's just put that in quotes. Anyways, let's close out of this bullshit. All right, so the first thing I highly recommend you go ahead and do is this over here. Now, if you are a NVIDIA user like me, I highly recommend that you go ahead and download the latest drivers. If you haven't done this already, this was released a few days ago. I highly recommend that you go ahead and download and install the latest drivers. If you are an NVIDIA user, it is 531.79. That's the latest graphics card drivers for NVIDIA users. Now, for AMD users, go ahead and look for the latest drivers, download it, and you should be good to go. It's very important that you keep your graphics card drivers up to date. Trust me, you need to do this. If you don't, you are going to lose FPS inside this game, and it's a big issue if you don't update your graphics card drivers. Please go ahead and do that. Okay, once you're done with that, all right, ladies and gentlemen, so the next step I highly recommend you go ahead and do is you're going to right-click on your desktop and go to NVIDIA Control Panel. If you are an NVIDIA user like me, you're going to open up NVIDIA Control Panel and you're going to go to Adjust Image Settings with Preview. Now, before you skip through my NVIDIA Control Panel settings, if you're a subscriber or if you've seen this of my videos and stuff like that, or you're a member of mine, there's something important I want to put out there. If you're new to my video, welcome. Alright, so something I want to point out is this over here. You're going to click on Use the Advanced 3D Image Settings, and you're going to click on Take Me There. Now, it's basically just going to take you to Manage 3D Settings. Now, something I want to explain is this over here. These things have changed now. They automatically change if you do a fresh installation or an updated version of your graphics card. It goes to its default shit. Now, I don't recommend that you play your game with its defaults. Don't play your games with this defaults. You are going to struggle with FPS. Your game might stutter and shit like that. Don't do that. You're going to come inside here and you're going to follow my settings. All right. So, the first thing we're going to go over is image scaling. You're going to turn this off. I'm not going to go very in detail with this, otherwise, I'm going to make this video way too fucking long, and I'm not keen on doing that. All right. So, just follow my settings and you should be good to go. Off. Ambient occlusion off, anisotropic filtering, application controlled. Okay, all of these, all the way from the top till here, keep it on application controlled. Gamma correction can be on, the rest are all off, and then this one is application controlled. Okay, this one, transparency, is still another thing that runs with all of these. You can turn it off. Okay, background application max frame rate off, okay, because this is for global, not a specific program. Okay, CUDA GPUs, you're going to click on this. And then you're going to select your GPU that you're currently running. So whatever dedicated graphics card you are running, you just select the dedicated graphics card and say okay. DSR factors is super resolution. If you want to use this, you can go ahead and do so. I don't use this at all. I play my game at its native resolution, so I don't use this. If you use this, it's your own personal preference. I'm not going to go in depth with this. Scroll down, You're going to come here to low latency mode. Now, as you can see, it's off. It automatically put this off for me when I installed the latest graphics card drivers to my machine. Now, this is wrong. You need to change this from off to on. Okay? Now, for people out there that only has the ultra option, go to ultra. Okay? Do not have this off. Never have this off. Low latency mode is going to help your GPU and your CPU keep up with one another much faster. If you have this off, your GPU and your CPU is not going to keep up with one another as fast as it should. Okay? That's basically what low latency mode is going to do for you right now. Okay? So you're going to keep this on. Max frame rate, you're going to keep this off because you're going to max out the frame rate inside your games. Multi-frame rate sampling, AA, you're going to turn this off. OpenGL rendering, you're not going to put this at auto. You're going to click on here and you're going to go to prefer performance. Okay? So it will push out more performance in your machine and it will make your games run much, much better. Okay? OpenGL rendering GPU, it's not auto select. You're going to come here and you're going to select your dedicated graphics card. Again, once again, you're going to select your GPU over here. Power management mode. A lot of people are using optimal power. The reason why they do that, and I've read it in my comments, is people are saying that it gives your GPU some breathing room. Now, for me, as a person that's been overclocking for years, I've overclocked my GPU, my CPU, and my RAM. I've been overclocking them for years. I prefer maximum performance on here. It gives you more performance on your GPU all the time. So you never have to come in here and click on this once you go in game. Just leave it like this. Yes, I know your GPU is going to work itself fucked up while you are not playing games, but your GPU won't fucking die. Trust me, you can have a 4090 or whatever GPU you have, the best GPU on the planet. Go with prefer maximum performance. Your GPU is not going to fucking die. It's not just going to blow up in your machine. Trust me, I've been doing overclocking for years. Trust me on this. All right, from here, shader cache. I highly recommend this has been changed to default driver. You are going to go to 100 gigs on this. You're going to scroll down. This helps for not just lag, stutters. It feels like lag. Because you're stuttering, it feels like your internet is slow or there's something wrong with the servers. It's actually not the servers. It's actually the shader cache inside your NVIDIA control panel that you need to set. Especially if you are an NVIDIA user and you are in these settings right now, change it to 100 gigs. Okay, I would recommend selecting this to off and just leaving it off completely. Okay, you're going to have this at allow and you're going to change this from quality over here to high performance. Have this at high performance, scroll down, texture filtering on, threaded optimization not on auto. You're going to click on this and you're going to go to on. Like Ryzen CPUs and Intel hyper-threaded CPUs and like you've got like 24 fucking cores and shit like that, I highly recommend you go ahead and turn this on. It helps for the game. Triple buffering, always off, and these are just virtual reality things. You do not need to give a fuck about this. You can apply these settings. Your screen might flash a couple of times, don't worry about it. It's just applying the settings for you. Now, I know I took a little bit long over here on this. Cool. Now, for my YouTube subscribers and my members, they already know what I'm going to do right now. So, if you are new to my video, you're going to come here and you're going to select your dedicated graphics card. Go ahead and do that. Do not have this at auto select. Do not have this at CPU. I highly recommend you go ahead and select your dedicated graphics card and say apply. Once you're done with that, you're going to come to adjust desktop color settings and you're going to come inside here. All right, that's my Call of Duty actually like doing something in the background. Anyways, so you're going to come inside here. You're going to have the brightness at 50% because you're going to change the brightness in your games instead of inside here. Okay, your contrast is at 65%. I highly recommend you put it at 65%. It doesn't matter what screen you're running, what display you're running, or even if you've got a gaming monitor, go with 65 over here. Trust me, it makes the game look much, much better. All right, the gamma default, and then your digital vibrance is your own personal preference. I click on image 3, and then you can see what it does to the colors inside this image. That's what it's going to do to your game. I have mine at 95. It's always been my sweet spot. And my subscribers and my loyal people to my channel know this already. This is my sweet spot. So go ahead and find your own sweet spot. Okay? You're going to apply these settings. Screen might flash a couple of times. All right. Let's jump over the next steps. So the next step I highly recommend you go ahead and do is you're going to go ahead and go to start and go to settings. You're going to come inside here. You're going to go to gaming. And you're going to go to game mode. Game mode needs to be turned on. Okay? If you have this off, go ahead and turn it on. From here, you're going to go to graphics settings and you're going to go to hardware accelerated GPU scheduling and turn this off. This gives stutters in the game. For some reason, it does. I don't know why this is a thing. I really don't know why. It's been like in season 2, it was on, and then when season 3 came out, it was off. It's like so fucked up with COD. I don't know why. It's like just a fucked up thing. Like, honest to God, it's just fucked. You have to physically find out weird things about your machine before you even play a fucking game. Like, Call of Duties have never been like this, and I don't know why we have to jump through fucking hoops and shit like that just to be able to play this game. Like, this is why I make these videos, is to help you guys out as best I can. And if this actually helped you, smash the motherfucking like button. I would appreciate it, and leave a comment down below if this shit actually worked for you. I would really fucking appreciate it. It takes a lot of time and dedication making these fucking videos. All right, so hardware accelerated GPU scheduling, you're gonna turn this off, okay? Have it off, and you're gonna go to the home button. You're gonna come to privacy, scroll all the way down, and you're gonna go to background apps, and you're gonna go from on to off. Turn all of these shit off that you have on your machine that's running in the background, that's using resources like your RAM, CPU, and your VRAM. These programs can actually use some of your VRAM, which you don't want that to do. And I'm going to show you why I turn this off. There's a setting in COD that shows over here where my mouse is right now. It says other apps inside COD's quality settings. It says other apps. These are the fucking other apps that's running in the background. You don't want it to be running, so turn it the fuck off. All right? Please, just go ahead and turn it off. All right, let's jump out of this. Let's jump straight into COD. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, I'm in my game right now, and welcome to beta Warzone rank play. And yeah, like it's pronounced, beta. It's completely fucked. So if you see anything like FPS loss and stuff like that, welcome. Welcome to Call of Duty releasing shit that's broken. Okay? That's pretty much what they do. They've always been doing it. Every time they release an update, they fuck this game up. And then I have to do so much fucking research to find out what is the best settings that you could be using to be able to play rank play without losing FPS. I'm getting emails and shit like that, messages and shit like that, where people are sending me messages saying, "Yo, dude, I've got a really good machine and I'm doing like 80 FPS while playing ranked, or 80 FPS in the lobby. I can't get anything higher than 80. Anything higher than 90. Now, right now, I'm doing 130 FPS if I don't record with OBS. Since I'm recording with OBS right now, it does eat a little bit of my VRAM. But anyways, so let's get over the settings. So you're going to go to this little gear icon over here and go to graphics. You're going to go to the quality tab over here and have this at custom, obviously. And then it's going to go to custom by itself if you start changing these things. Right now, I'm playing my game at Intel's upscaling and sharpening with ultra quality. It makes the game look like a AAA title game, and my machine is capable of running it. I have overclocked my CPU, I've overclocked my GPU, and I've overclocked my RAM. My RAM timings are shorter, so I do better FPS, and it's much faster. It's more responsive in general. Okay? This is why I use this. I have my video memory scale at 90%. I have my game at normal right now. It runs perfectly fine. High, high, and high. Okay. So if you've got a really decent enough machine, mine's not the best, but I can run my game like this. So if you have anything like mine and better, run it with this. It makes the game look really, really good. I highly recommend you use it. Okay, so for people out there that's losing FPS, I highly recommend that you use NVIDIA DLSS. This is one option you can go for. Then go with quality. Don't go with balance. Don't go with performance. Don't go with ultra performance. Your game's gonna look like dog shit. You could go to balance. If you really need to, you could go with balance, okay? The game still looks okay, but I don't recommend it. I would recommend quality over here. It does make the game look much, much better, and some of the blur goes away on the left and right-hand side of your screen. So I would recommend that you use the quality on NVIDIA DLSS, the sharpen all the way up to 100%, and have your video memory scale at 90% over here. Okay, now, if you do not use NVIDIA DLSS or you don't have it, okay, I would recommend using the NVIDIA image scaling and having this at native. Do not change it to ultra quality, quality, balance, or performance. Don't use it as your native, and it will run your native resolution if you're running a 720p monitor, 1080p, 1440p, 2K, 4K, whatever the fuck resolution you are playing your game at right now. This native will push it to that resolution of your monitor. Have the sharpen at 10. Trust me, at 10 it looks really good. If you push it up, it starts looking all fuzzy and shit. But that's your own personal preference. This is literally your own personal preference over here. Filmic SMA 82 times, ultra quality, 90% on the video memory scale. Go for it. All right. Then from here, if you don't use this and you use AMD FSR, this actually does increase FPS if you're in need of FPS. If your machine is struggling really bad, go with AMD FSR 1.0 and go with ultra quality over here. You can go with quality if you want to. It will push out at least 20 FPS more if you put this at quality, going from ultra quality to quality. Trust me, it does work. Now, the thing I was talking about earlier on in my NVIDIA control panel is this other apps and shit like that. As you can see, I'm using a gig of my card right now. I'm using 1 gig of my card. Now, the reason why I'm using 1 gig of my card right now, I have not gone out of this game after changing my NVIDIA control panel settings, okay? So I'm going to show you what it looks like after changing the NVIDIA control panel settings. Because a lot of people skip through my NVIDIA control panel settings and they jump straight into this video where my settings is. And then they say like, yo, dude, this isn't working. The reason why it's not fucking working is because you're skipping through my fucking video. That's why it's not fucking working. I'm trying my best here to help you guys. So don't skip through my fucking video. You need to go through every single step that I'm taking in my videos for you to get the settings right. For your game to run correctly. Okay? So I'm going to go back to my settings that I'm using currently. Okay? So this is my settings. I'm going to apply it. Cool. I don't have to apply anything or reset anything or whatever the fuck. As you can see, I'm using 1 gig of other apps, okay? I'm going to close out of my game quickly and just show you something. So I'm just going to say yes, close out of my game completely, and then I'm going to relaunch my game, okay? So here we go. So let's go with this. Now, I'm going to relaunch my game and actually show you that my other apps are going to be lower now because I disabled all my background apps. I changed things in my NVIDIA control panel that helps that little situation there where it says other apps. I highly recommend that you go ahead and follow those steps that I just fucking showed you, okay? Then something I also recommend you do is, if you have any background apps running like this, I have Wallpaper Engine running like this, this is Wallpaper Engine, close it. Just go like this, boom, close, and then there you go. I have a stock background picture at the back. It actually increases the game to run smoother. Okay, so here we go. I'm launching into my game right now. Now let me show you something. If I go here, and I go to graphics, and I go to the quality tab, and I go over inside here, as you can see, I still have all my shit the same. 423 megs is being used by my GPU right now. So like I said, ladies and gentlemen, you need to follow my video step by step. Don't skip through my shit, okay? I've been doing this for quite some time, and I've realized where it says top moments in my video on my YouTube, the top moments is only inside the settings. You guys need to fucking physically go through all my stuff for your game to run well. Not just this. If you only change these settings inside here, it's not going to help you much. Trust me, it's fucking not. The game's unoptimized, so you need to jump through hoops and go through certain settings for your game to run perfectly fine. Okay? As you can hear in my voice, I'm quite fed up with the developers, and I'm also sick as fuck, and I don't want to repeat myself and sound like a fucking broken record, but yeah, the developers are smoking some fat crack, and I don't know what the fuck they are doing, okay? Anyways, so, like I said, I play my game like this, it runs perfectly fine. A lot of people are running their game at Fidelity FX Cache. If you are running your game at Fidelity FX Cache because you are losing a lot of FPS and you don't have the best of machines, then I would recommend using Fidelity FX Cache. Go to 60% over here, go over here to about 60. You can actually type in what you want here. So you can put in 65 if you want to, press enter and apply it. Always have this at Filmic SMA 82 times, otherwise you're going to have this little weird shit happening on your screen, and you don't want that. Ultra quality over here, have this at normal. Then, something I want to mention is, if your machine can't handle this game perfectly fine, then go with low. There's not a lot of visual difference between normal and low. So go with low over here if you're going to play ranked play. Okay. Then something that plays a very, very big role is these three over here. Leave them at high. It doesn't matter what machine you are running. leave them at high, because if you turn them to low, your game's gonna look like shit. Trust me, it's gonna look like absolute dog shit. Don't change this, okay? Now, the rest of the settings, you can just copy all of these. You can just go ahead and copy them. I'm not gonna make this video any longer than what it already is. Just copy my settings inside here, and you should be good to go. Okay, I'm not going to apply these settings because I have my settings already as is. So I'm just going to go over here to interface and say discard. You're going to come to interface and you're going to go to color customization. Go to filter 2, both 100%, 100%. And then you're going to come here to enemy and choose a specific color for your enemy to be. I have mine a pink over here. And this is magenta pink because it's a very sharp color to find your enemies, especially if you ping them or... if you see your enemy, it's fucking pink. Trust me, it's really fucking pink. If you're a subscriber on my YouTube channel or a member on my YouTube channel, you'll see that, yeah, pretty much this is all still the same. But the settings has changed. The season, the reloaded version, has changed a lot. It has. It really has. Okay? Now, I don't want to make this video too long. This will be the last step that you're going to need to do. Is this over here. You're going to go to your graphics settings, you're going to go to display, you're going to come to restart shader optimization, you're going to click on this, you're going to click on restart, you're going to completely close out of your game, relaunch your game, and then at the top left corner here, it's going to say installing shaders, let it finish, don't touch your keyboard, don't touch your mouse, let it finish, let it apply the settings. Ladies and gentlemen, if this worked for you, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you're new here, and as always, just here to help the Call of Duty community as best I can. And peace out.